This is my review of Aurini's version of the rough draft preview of the Sarkeesian effect that him and Jordan Nolan are making and having this big feud over. And there's lots of hype and lots of drama surrounding it. Possibly some fraud. Not going to say it's fraud, but no, it's fraud. So they asked a bunch of money. They asked people to make a bunch of money to make this great film that's going to impress everybody and it's going to get national attention and people are going to stop listening to Anita Sarkeesian because it's going to be so good at debunking everything that she does and the premises that she relies on. And look, if you really think that Aurini and Jordan Owen are going to make anything great, considering that they've never made any quality fucking content in their entire lives, then you're a fucking moron, and you and a fool and his money are easily parted, and you're just more of an example of that. So I'm going to get into the reasons why I thought that this preview was shit. So first thing, it does not play like a documentary. It plays like a YouTube critique of someone. So much so that they actually had to use clips of other people's critiques of Anita Sarkeesian in it because they said things better. You know, there were better things said by better people. And when Thunderfoot is a better person than you, you really need to reevaluate your life. But they used clips of Thunderfoot's critiques and other people's critiques in order to make their points. That's how bad it was. When they started getting into the interviews, they were injecting themselves into the interview. So you saw Aurini and Jordan Owen sitting, having a dialogue between, you know, people. And you know, like these people were, you know, making points against Anita Sarkeesian, or at least the premises that people like Sarkeesian do. And which is fine if you're just going to have like a dialogue or whatever for a YouTube video, but this is supposed to be a film that people are supposed to be taking seriously. But it's not. You can't take it seriously because that's not how documentaries are made. And all, whatever. Jim Jesus doesn't know anything about film. I went to film school. I'm going to post a link below of Aurini's quote-unquote film, and you can tell me if the guy knows anything about film because it's so fucking garbage. It's even actually worse than this, but that's another topic. So, Aurini, you don't know anything about film. Don't pretend that you do. Just because you worked on a few films doesn't mean you know anything about them, okay? Ed Wood made a couple of films. What's your point? So, first of all, if you need narration in a documentary, you don't have the footage to make a point, to push a narrative, and you're just filling in the gap by using shitty narration. And usually, for me, when I hear a documentary with narration, it usually means that someone is trying to bullshit me. That's what it means. And it may not be the case with this particular thing, but that's usually the case for me. I could do a whole video about how documentaries with narrators are fucking garbage, but that's another topic. But they're trying to do like this Michael Moore thing where they're sitting down having a back and forth with someone, which is like a different style of documentary. Yes, but as bad as Michael Moore is, he's funny. So when he's having this back and forth with someone, like, he's usually trying to be funny. Like, he's making a joke or something. And there was one point where Aurini tries to make a joke, but it wasn't like terribly unfunny. It was just like, this would only be funny like if I was in that conversation. It's not like, ha 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 ha, oh, that's a great joke, oh, I'm gonna tell my friends at work about this funny part. There's nothing funny, like really that funny about it. It's just kind of like, okay, you know, I'm an outsider, that's not interesting to me because, you know, I'm not part of the conversation, so it's not really a funny joke to me. But they try to present it that way. And so no, they need to be taken out of the documentary. If you have a good interviewee, all you really need to do is sit behind the camera and not inject yourself unnecessarily into the Anita Sarkeesian story, because they don't have anything to do with the Anita Sarkeesian story. They're just trying to inject themselves in there for status. They need to be off of the camera, asking the question, and then cutting their question out of the film, and just, you know, unless it's absolutely necessary, and just let the answers make the narration for the story. No narrator, do that. That's what makes a great documentary. All the great documentaries that I can think of follow that formula, because that's how good interviewing and good documentary filmmaking is done. Is you just let people make that narrative for you. And they didn't do that. They just wanted to inject themselves in it. And it was cringeworthy to watch. And then I don't know if this is going to be the case with the rest of the film or if this is going to the final cut, but there was at the very beginning where they go from, you know, the little quick introduction to the intro title where that has the animation. I guess the animation's not done yet because it just says, like, you know, animation goes here. And then it has, like, this music that is so bad. It's like someone just figured out how to make multi-track recording with their fucking Casio, or not even Casio, that's being over gelled, you know, like a keyboard that they bought from Best Buy. They just figured out how to play the thing, and they just figured out that they can record things onto a floppy disk, and now they're trying to make some quick little thing for whatever reason, and it sounds terrible. It's god awful. Like, I was listening to it, like, this is what you're going with. You took money, you could have paid a musician. Owen could have recorded something because he's a musician, right? Maybe he did record this. Maybe he's responsible for this. I don't know. I've never heard his music. And they could have made something nice, right? Or bought licenses to another song or something. But it was so fucking unlistenable. And keeping in the same vein as the audio, because this is going to be the rest of the critique of the video. I mean, there were some video issues either that, you know, there was you know, the color correction wasn't right. There was inconsistency between the two. And maybe Aurini has some skill with that, and that was what he was talking about. But there was no excuse for the audio, not even for a rough draft. So there was parts in the very first where he was using this effect. It's kind of like, it sounds like he was talking into a radio, where he was talking about, like, topic one, topic two, topic three, topic four. And every time he said, like, topic one, it'd be like,
topic one.
Topic one is something blah blah blah, but he would use that effect so inconsistently, and there was even a point where he used that wonky effect to highlight, I think it was a quotation, I don't remember correctly, I think it was a quotation, and then you're just kind of like, you're just confused, like, okay, so is he really using, like, this as an effect to highlight the different topics, or is he using it as filler, you know, like a shitty microphone filler, so he knows where to put the good recording of it in? It didn't make any sense, but it seems like he was trying to use that as an effect. And then as far as the levels and everything, the very first part was great, but then it jumps to part two and all of a sudden Arini's loud and I have to, like, turn down my audio. Now, again, I understand it's a rough draft, but how hard is it really to turn down a slider on a fucking computer if he's using Vegas? It seems like he said he was using Vegas. So that I don't have to turn down the volume of the things to make it. This is what you paid for. Shit. And you guys got shit. And I'm laughing at every single one of you. If you really thought that Aurini or Owen would ever make anything good, considering they've never have, why would you start thinking that now and give them all this money? Look, everything that they said in this video would be completely unconvincing to anyone who didn't agree with it before. Anyone who has a nuanced opinion isn't going to be swayed either way. People who are on the fence are not going to come to either one side. And even they're even doing things like, oh, Marxism. We're just going to throw the word Marxism out there. Like, oh, look at this evil feminist monster. You know, like, she's known to be a feminist monster. It'd be like, you're like, oh, you know, like, I'm just trying to paint feminism in a bad light. You know, what's her name? Valerie Salinas, the guy that shot Andy Warhol. Oh, look at her. Look at her. Oh, terrible. All of them are. They're kind of doing that. For example, I'm sure a lot of people are following me are libertarians. Like what if I said, like, oh, Pinochet. Oh, Pinochet. Oh, Pinochet. Nazis. Oh, Nazis. You just roll your eyes. Like, what are you doing? And that's essentially what they're doing to the left. It's not going to convince anybody. It's not going to convince anybody on the other side. You're only preaching to the choir. And this is what they're trying to make a film that reaches a broader audience to kind of eliminate the Sarkeesian effect that they think is happening. And it's not going to do it. You're gonna go into this agreeing with the video. You're gonna come out agreeing with it. It's absolute garbage. You wasted your money. Ha ha. And if it's even wasted your money even more if you gave it to Aurini, because I'm not saying that he's a fraud. No, he's a fraud. Anyways, that's my review of it. It wasn't really by itself. It wasn't really worth this. What, 10 minutes almost now? Really worth the 10 minutes that I spent talking about it? If it wasn't for all the drama surrounding it and the characters behind it, because it was really that bad. doesn't deserve any attention, but because it has those two faces on it, I guess I just wanted to kind of laugh as I'm throwing on the last couple shovels full of dirt onto this fucking shit project. Ha ha, ha ha ha, suckers. Worms.